Through two examples, we have respectively introduced why return is important and how to calculate it. Now let us formally introduce the concept of state value. To explain state value, we must first introduce some symbols. Let's look at this simple single-step process. Here, ST represents the current state, while the action taken in this state is denoted as AT. The reward received is RT plus 1, and the subsequent state is ST plus 1. The T denotes the current moment, and T plus 1 denotes the next moment. Their specific meanings are described here. It is worth noting that RT plus 1 can also be written as RT, meaning the reward received at state ST from taking action, AT, is RT. As a convention, however, we often write it as RT plus 1. Mathematically, there is no difference between the two. It's merely a matter of convention. Note that all S, A, and R are in uppercase, representing random variables. A random variable allows for various operations, such as expectation. Furthermore, in this process, all these transitions are determined by probability distributions. For example, the action taken at ST is decided by the policy. The reward received from action AT is determined by the reward probability, and the next state transition to after taking action AT is dictated by the state transition probability. This single-step process can be extended to a multi-step trajectory. Starting from ST, taking action AT leads to the next state, receiving a reward, and this continues to form a multi-step trajectory. We can calculate the discounted return for this trajectory, denoted by the symbol GT, which sums up these immediate rewards, while considering the discount rate gamma. Since RT plus 1, RT plus 2, and so on, are all random variables, GT is also a random variable. After introducing the necessary symbols, we are now ready to formally define state value, which is actually quite simple. We know that GT is the discounted return for a trajectory. What is state value? It is the expectation of GT, which is also called expected value, mean, or average. Essentially, these terms all denote the same quantity, the expectation. The full name for state value is state value function, commonly shortened to state value. We represent state value by V pi s. Mathematically, it is defined as the expectation of GT. However, this is a conditional expectation based on the assumption that the current state is S. There are several key points to note. First, V pi s is a function of state S, implying that different starting states S lead to different trajectories and naturally to different returns and then different state values. Second, it is based on the policy pi. This function can also be expressed as Vs pi, placing pi as a variable within the parentheses. But, for simplicity, we use V pi s, with pi positioned in the subscript. It is obvious that different policies result in different trajectories, which in turn lead to different returns and consequently different state values. Moreover, the value in state value is not just a numeric value, it also indicates its worth. If the state value is greater, then the policy is better, because greater cumulative rewards can be obtained. Now, let's answer this question. What is the relationship between return and state value? In our motivating examples, we repeatedly discussed return, and now we are defining state value. What exactly is the difference and relationship between them? The answer is quite straightforward. Return is calculated for a single trajectory, whereas state value is the average of returns of multiple trajectories. If starting from a state, we may have multiple trajectories. Then, it's clear that there is a difference between return and state value. However, if everything is deterministic so that starting from a state leads to only one possible trajectory, then the return and the state value of that state would be identical. Let's consider the three examples we have seen in our motivating examples, corresponding to three policies, pi1, pi2, and pi3. We aim to calculate the state value of the same state, S1, under these three different policies. The calculation is relatively simple because for the first policy, the state value is straightforward. Starting from here, we will have a unique trajectory, and the return of this trajectory is its state value, which we have already calculated. The second state value is also simple, being the return along its trajectory. The third is slightly more complicated due to two possible trajectories. The state value is the average return for the two trajectories, This averaging is done by multiplying the probabilities in front, essentially calculating an expectation. Then we can obtain such a value. It becomes evident that Vπ1 is the highest, Vπ2 is the lowest, and Vπ3 is in the middle. Therefore, we know the first policy is the best and the second policy is the worst.